anybody interested, this is how we stoke the fire. See, this right here is an oven, old-timey oven, get me? We don't use it. We warm food on and stuff in it, but, you know, that's not all. The real oven's over there. Anyway, it runs off of electricity. That modern convenience, you know? Anyway, this is the oven, okay? You know, I imagine they bake old things in there, I don't know. Anyway, this is the temperature gauge, which registers up to 700. I've gotten it up to 550 before. I'm trying to break 700. Whew. It's hot. This is where the fire goes, okay? And it's burning real nice right now, actually. We use coal over here to burn with, because it's like a popular thing, you know? God, that's hot. Anyway, I need to clean that off. I'm going to write my name in it. David. Yes, there we go. Anyway, down here is where that's where all the ashes fall down. This is where you stick all this coal in. Coal burns, causes ashes. Get it? Okay, this is what we call a coal scoop, you know? And we're going to throw coal in there. And the most convenient way is, instead of getting your hands all grubby and everything, by using a glove and stuff, throwing it in there and burning your hands and stuff, you know? Because, you know, like, I'm missing a couple of fingers now. Like, they're still there, don't worry. Anyway, we take this, which is full of coal. Well, actually, it's about right here right now with coal. But we take it and we position ourselves like this, okay? Can you see? Can you see? Can you see? Can you see? Okay, here we go. You need to just put it in there like that. Try this at home. It is very dangerous. Seeing as how y'all don't have a fireplace, it'll be even more dangerous, you know, to start a fire in the living room floor, you know, no problem. It's just carpet, right? Anyway, we'll be back. Now, what we're going to do here is, what you see on the screen now is 8 hot dogs, okay, in the package. Now, this is a delicate technique of how to unwrap hot dogs, okay? Slowly poke the knife in there. You do not want to puncture a hot dog. A punctured hot dog boils really strange and it comes out cut whenever you're done, actually. Okay. Use only the finest. Swift Premium is a nice brand. Plus, it's only the only kind that I could get. Anyway. Now, like I was saying, you unwrap the hot dog, okay? And I shall return, you know. This is sign language for any of you deaf folk, okay? Let me get a pan, okay? Pans are kept in the other room. Here, talk to Mr. Knight for a while. Okay, this is what we call a pan. For all you beginner, inexperienced cooks, this is a pan. These are hot dogs, and this is a knife. Okay. Take several hot dogs, as many as you want to eat, and throw them in there, okay? And you're ready. Oh, ooh, what an aroma. I wish we had smell-o-vision. Yes, now you need hot water. And you can't see me, but I am filling this with hot water. Okay, now that you have the hot dogs, water, pan. Get it? Ha-ha. Okay, knife. Disregard the knife now. Throw it in the sink and clean it later. Okay. Now, we have several hot dogs ready to be cooked. Now, for a nice evening snack, this is a nice amount, but we'd like to add more. Okay, here we go. Now, we're going to take you over to the oven. We shall return in just a few minutes. Remember, hot dogs, water, pan. Now is the top of the oven, or the stove. This is the old stove. It's hot already. Why bother with turning on a hot and get it all heated up? This electric one over here. Very well then. As you can see, we are boiling the hot dogs now. It will take a while for them to boil. Would you like to watch them boil? Well, no. See, the old wives' tale. Actually, if you watch water boiling, or watch a pan of cold water start to boil, it'll never boil. That's what the wives tell me. Well, I'm here to tell you, I'm a science of physics now, okay? And This pan will boil no matter how long you watch it. It will eventually boil at the same amount of given allotted time that it would take for a normal hot dog to boil. Anyway, as I was saying, we've got six hot dogs here. Hot dog pan water, you know? Neat. Handle. You carry it by this. Because this will get hot. You carry it by this and it won't get hot. Plastic. Plastic does not get hot. It melts, but it just does not get hot. Anyway, like I was saying, we have a pan stove. We're ready to go. We'll let that cook for a while, then I will show you how to make the ultimate hot dog. See you later. Okay, folks. Let's boil. You would like to add, this is the secret to hot dog heaven. You make it with tequila, okay? You add a little tequila here. You know, a little, you know, whatever you like, you know. And then some people, they prefer eggs in it. You know, I like eggs in my hot dogs. It's a wonderful thing, you know. There we go. One fried egg for the hot dog. Okay, and why add mustard? Why add mustard, you say, huh? What do people put on their hot dogs, huh? They put hot dog relish and stuff like this. Mustard. I don't like hot dog relish. I like mustard. So why add it afterwards? Why not put it in right now? There we go, yeah. Add the mustard. There we go, yes. Okay, I like my hot dog sweet, you know? A little bit of sweetness in a hot dog never hurts. So all you gotta do is, you know, pick something sweet, like, oh, here we have strawberry jam. We'll add some strawberry jam here. You know, it's nice. It goes along with a hot dog well. There we go. Clean the spoon later. Okay. This is cooking from my kitchen. Okay, I like a little plastic or something, you know, whatever you want in there. You know, put it in there, you know, make sure you stir it up nicely. Now, doesn't that look nice? Okay, there we go, yes. We shall return. Thank you. Is the plate prepared for the ultimate hot dogs ever made in the world, okay? And bread plate countertop, okay? Let's not get them confused, because if you put the hot dog on the countertop, it comes to be messy, okay? Anyway, so remember, bread plate countertop, yes. Little army man. Okay. I like a lot of mustard, okay? So, I've added it already in the strawberry jam, the tequila, and, you know, the ultimate hot dog is ready. It should be boiling here, so we add a little bit of mustard here. You know, you can write your name, whichever, you know. These little tops are wonderful. They just do tremendous things to cooking. Let's see. Now, then, we need a fork to pull the hot dogs out with. So, we pull the hot dogs out. There we go. Ooh, they're hot. Yep, see all the steam? See steam. Steam rising. Remember, handle. You do not burn yourself with this. Okay, if you lift it by here, it hurts. Okay, we have one hot dog. They're reluctant to come off of the fork, unfortunately. Now that we have a completely boiled hot dog, you set it on there, and there we go, yes. You can add whatever you'd like to it, you know. Whichever, you know, eggshell is lovely for the side. You know, a little eggshell on there. You know, dress it up, make it look nice. You know, lovely, isn't it? I wish we had smell-o-vision. Now we're ready to eat the ultimate hot dog in the world here. Listen, turn the stereo down some. Okay, very well. Very, very well. I wish we had smell-o-vision. Okay. The ultimate hot dog here. We're gonna taste it. I'm gonna move this out of your way. Okay. This is a Sun newspaper. One of the dailies over here in Britain. Now the thing that makes it sell is the page three girl. Now page three girls appear topless. Oops, sorry lady. In the newspaper. And they have them every day. And they're neat. So, needless to say, I have a 10-year subscription to Sun newspaper. No, not really. Anyway, I'm gonna enjoy these hot dogs. All six of them. You only see two right now.